No, güey, trae una toalla. Uno de los dos, o sea, no, 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 pasa, no,
no, pasa el tiempo. Miguel, by the way, congratulations on your win, man. You knocked your opponent down in the third and ninth round, man. Seems like he was a tough, rugged opponent, man. A tough, crafty veteran. Tell me about that.
You know, he was tough. He could take a punch. You know, he tried to bullshit his way around the fight a lot, which was, you know, probably what kept him in the fight. Also, that extra weight, that he had. He had those 4 extra pounds.
Right.
But I think, you know, the times I dropped him, I was just trying to stay calm. You know, there's been a lot of times I've dropped fighters and I get reckless, so things go bad. So I just try to remain calm, man, and you know, get the W. It don't matter if it was decision or KO, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, fighting at home, did you feel any type of pressure this time around? I mean, since you, or did you feel any sort of difference because you've been out in the ring for 11 months?
Yeah. Rust is obviously there. Rust and being out the ring so many months, man, it's not good, especially when you're my age. I don't want to say I'm old, but I am 32. And it was a little extra pressure. Because we were at home and you know, I had all my people, all my crowd. And that's exactly why I didn't want to let that get the best of me. Like, when I dropped them, I didn't want to get super anxious. You know, I didn't want to get reckless. I said it before the fight. I had to remain calm and not let the people, the crowd, get me too excited, you know?
Okay. Did you fight with any more emotions on this fight around? Because I did see you walked around with your a shirt dedicating it to somebody as well.
Yeah, no, that's my brother, man. He's been in my shirt since fucking my first pro fight. Right here on my trunks, Benjamin. He, you know, my late brother. He passed away after a fight, and this is the reason. He's the reason why we're all here, actually. If it wasn't for him, none of us wouldn't have been possible, man.
Okay.
He paved the way. He always told me to remain humble. That's his main words. Always remain humble. And that's what got me here today, man.
Okay. And then, I don't know, in the 10th round, you did hit your him on the side of the head. I did see that that hard wince. You know, how's your hand feeling right now?
It's good. It's not. It was just pain at the moment. My stablemate, Jenny Fuchs, congratulations to her, WBC interim champion. She fought 10 rounds with a broken thumb, that shit was sticking out. So when I hurt my hand, I was like, fuck, all right, fuck it. The show must go on, right?
Absolutely.
So congratulations to her. This was nothing. My respects to her. Congratulations, Jenny.
Yeah, absolutely. And then I also just got word spoke to Regis Progre, your gym stablemate as well. He was congratulating you. He was just really proud of your performance as well.
Regis, man, we've been stablemates for many years.